great Wednesday evening, 3/24/2021. To God be the glory for the closing of another day. I did not realize that we were in the absolute last chapter of Joshua. I forgot that there are only 24 sections. And this is the chapter where Joshua is giving his absolute last closing statements. We know that he gave a farewell speech before, and he told the Israelites to be very courageous and to stay faithful and to take good heed therefore unto yourselves, to pay attention. Well, in this chapter, pretty much he's asking the people, are you all really ready? And we have to ask ourselves this evening, are we really serving the Lord and worshiping him? Because it says in this chapter that God will not tolerate any rivals. He is a jealous God. He is one who wants allegiance, and he will give us his grace, his mercy, his love. He wants us to focus in on him. And the people answered after Joshua said, choose you this day who you're going to serve. Make a choice. Make a choice. And in verse 15, the last part, it says, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Is that your declaration? Is that your proclamation this evening? No matter what will happen, your family, your household. Yeah. You want generational faith. And the way to do that is to live the life and demand. And pray, model. I was speaking to a parent today, and she showed me something that a student, you know, had in her possession. And I was like, this is not even of her character. Because I know the life you have lived. I know the life your husband have lived. And this is not even her. So, don't you worry. I understand your response, but you have provided a blueprint. Yeah. So that's what we have to do to bring in others to the fold. Timotheus, do you have something to say about making a choice or household faith, or think about your ancestors, like how your grandfather was a pastor and your grandmother was a very holy woman. Both sides. And my parents, and you got to make a choice. And something with this chapter, we're all going to come to this point, and it came to pass. Those five words. We think we're going to live forever. Joshua lived to be 110 years old, and that's wonderful. But some of us won't even live half of that, 55 years, or even half of that, 27 and a half. Or even half of that. So what do we do with the time that we have? Let's make sure that we're serving the Lord. And when they said, choose ye this day, and as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord, we would have gone to Proverbs 24. And it talks about with wisdom is a house built, a family built. And it talks about all the components of a family and a house. God has to be the cornerstone. Without him, it fails. It says, unless the Lord builds a house, the laborers labor in vain. So it says, through wisdom is a house built, and by understanding is it established, is firm. And by knowledge shall the chambers, the rooms, be filled with all precious and pleasant gifts. What spoke to you in either chapter?
Verse 27
of Proverbs 24. Prepare thy work without, and make it fit for thyself in the field, and afterwards build thine house. Look at that.
I think because it's good to prepare for things first before jumping right in them, and to know like that where things are. Like I saw a video today, and it was like a guy like putting nails in a wall, and like he had to use a stud finder to find where the stud was mm-hmm. before he put it in the wall. So it's like you have to prepare things first before just going into them blindly. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's how I want to be with everything I do.
Amen. Well, you're talking about a house, and that's going right in line. Building a house, one day you're going to build a family, you're going to build a structure. You want to be able to have as a solid foundation, the solid rock. You want to build your life on the blueprint, the foundation of the Lord, so that when the storms come, they're inevitable, you'll be able to stand. You won't be rocked. I'm just looking at a house that we were drawing. I think this was the second grade. But yeah, you want your house, you want your structure solid. And the Lord is the one who will provide the direction so that all of your whole household can be blessed. But the first thing is you got to make a choice. Choose ye this day, choose ye every day for a life. And then you're going to see that you're blessed. And then you're going to see all the precious and pleasant gifts are there, knowledge and wisdom and understanding. And woo, you have a lifetime of true joy. All right. Have a great evening building on the Lord.